Hello everyone, this is Masa Funahashi and I'm representing SynecO Inc. SynecO Inc. is a new Sony Group company established a few years ago. It is the first Sony Group company that fosters nature-positive solutions as the main purpose and value. Our nature-positive solution is based on the technologies called Synecoculture and Augmented Ecosystems. Today, I'd like to introduce these new technologies. This is the figure from the famous Bending the Curve paper published in Nature. It advocates the importance of conservation and regeneration of biodiversity compared to the most degraded state in 2022. But we can also think of a better practice that goes beyond the historical level or even constructs high biodiversity beyond the natural state. This is what we call the augmentation scenario. And the major driver for this is actually human activities. You can see here the image of natural ecological succession from bare land to grassland, shrubs, woodland, and climax forest. The idea of augmented ecosystems is that human impact, such as farming, energy production, and other constructions positively enhance biodiversity with proper assessment and supportive technologies. The scientific rationale for this new paradigm has been already published in many scientific papers, including a perspective from Nature Research Journal. I cannot get into details in this short presentation, but showing some references for the scientists here. So let's see more practically the essential basis of synecoculture and more generally augmented ecosystems. It is based on the construction of ecosystems with dense and diverse mixtures of useful species. Synecoculture is a farming method with more than 200 edible plant species, which self-organize to create a bountiful ecosystem from which we obtain multiple harvests and profit from other ecosystem services. We utilize emergent ecosystem functions to replace conventional interventions, so there's no plowing, no fertilization, and no chemical treatment. Such a high level of biodiversity requires technical support for the assessment and management of huge ecological complexity. We have an exploration interface for the biological interactions based on big data that allows us to enrich the introduction of edible species and strengthen positive interactions within the ecological network. Usually, it demands intensive expert knowledge to perform such analysis, but we developed an artificial intelligence that can scale up such assessment using drone images. We can also construct a three-dimensional virtual ecosystem platform for effective communication through online support. Using these technologies, we are promoting synecoculture and augmented ecosystems throughout the world. Here are the top priority areas we consider important based on the current state of biodiversity loss and industrial interest. For the rest of this presentation, I will introduce some ongoing projects that are developing in these areas. The environmental crisis is a common threat in sub-Saharan Africa. I convey the knowledge of synecoculture in the semi-arid region of Burkina Faso in the Sahel in 2015. This is the initial picture of our pilot farm, where we gathered 150 edible plant species to form a synecoculture field. Throughout the pilot experience of 3 years, the synecoculture field remained covered with lots of edible plants compared to the reference area without any intervention that remained bare. We had a significant local economic impact that this small farm could actually make strong life support for the village. The productivity was extremely high, as well as the product quality, so we collaborated with local government to scale up this project. So far, we have held 6 symposia on synecoculture in the Sahel under the support of the UNESCO UNITFIN program and established an NGO for the propagation of synecoculture on a continental scale. Today, we have the engagement of civil society, such as NGOs and universities, which formed an open collaboration network. Without external funding, we already realized more than 10 training farms in 8 African countries. SynecO Inc. is also working with them to provide certification for synecoculture farms. Yeah, also working on the automation of synecoculture by combining it with the production of renewable energy and robotics. This year, a collaborating company had started an initial experiment in Kenya. Other than Africa, China has a great potential to turn into nature positive. For the last few years, synecoculture has been rapidly propagating through the efforts of Sony China. All production sites and entertainment sites of Sony actually introduce synecoculture as a part of CSR activities, and it is even growing into businesses in collaboration with local farms and communities. Sony China is promoting environmental value through synecoculture. This year, we had two expos in Shanghai, which attracted more than 11,000 audience and more than 100 million views on national media. Actually, 97% of visitors reclaimed environmental activities as an important reason for their product choice, so there's a huge potential for the adoption of nature-positive solutions. This is another example from South America. Local producers and international suppliers of cacao are seeking ways to make the current production more sustainable and make the local community more resilient to climate change. In this pilot project in Ecuador, we have transformed a monoculture cacao farm into synecoculture that comprises more than 200 edible plant species. It produces not only an equivalent amount of cacao, but also 25 tons per hectare of non-cacao crops. We can see where there is also an alternative way for cash crop production. Now let's focus on the city environment. I participated in the committee of this World Economic Forum report that examined the nature-related risks in the urban environment. It says almost half of the economic activities are at risk of severe disruption if we do not transform them into nature-positive ways. In Tokyo, there are increasing risks with extreme weather events such as heat islands and strong rains. So we started the experiment of a rooftop synecoculture garden on top of a building. It not only showed a mitigation capacity for heat and rain, but also provided an essential platform for environmental education. We created the learning kit for augmented ecosystems, namely SynecO portal, in which we can learn about biodiversity and ecosystem functions by creating a small augmented ecosystems. SynecO portal is actually deployed in several schools in Japan through Sony's education program and consultation by SynecO Inc. We expect to engage more service industries such as education into nature-positive activities. We also focus on the healthcare industry, especially in the aging society. We have collaborated with a rehabilitation center for elderly patients and established a program that includes rehabilitation activities in the synecoculture field. It shows significant amelioration, and we have initial medical evidence published in the Humboldt Institute book. We now have a general model that links biodiversity with our healthcare costs, and we are providing composite services to first augment the biodiversity toward a safe level, then explore its utility through multiple usage of ecosystem services, including personalized lifestyle medicine supported by medical data and AI. Through this presentation, I hope you become more convinced by this picture now. Compared to natural ecosystem that is usually conserved out of human intervention, augmented ecosystems have multiple leveraging points, both for human and ecological health. Essential human activities such as farming, energy production, urbanization, education, and healthcare can at the same time contribute to biodiversity and carbon fixation by building augmented ecosystems. Today, we are using up to 1.7 times of Earth's regenerative capacity of the global ecosystem. It is called ecological footprint and is considered a key indicator of sustainability in the Dasgupta report. If we comply with nature-positive solutions such as augmented ecosystem, there's still hope to keep our ecological footprint within the planetary boundary. I projected a forecast, and it showed we need to gather our effort to transform 2 to 4% of our GDP each year to be derived from nature-positive solutions, and we'll be self-sufficient within one Earth capacity in 10 to 20 years. I think this is the big picture that we all have to keep in mind. To achieve such a global goal, only acting within Sony Group is not sufficient, and we are extending our multi-stakeholder activities to become inclusive of other companies, NGOs, universities, and public sectors, all these efforts to mutually contribute to the establishment of natural social common capital. I hope we have a chance to collaborate on such a perspective soon. And I hereby acknowledge the collaborators who contributed to the project. For more information, please visit our website. Thanks for your kind attention.